Hello, what's up guys, welcome to the new video. Today we will learn about the degrees and the radians. Now what is degree? The unit of angle measurement is degree, and we usually measure the angle by degrees. The whole circle has 360 degrees or 360 parts. Now this is the small circle you can see over here, that this represents the degrees. We usually use this small circle above the numbers. For example, 7 degree, you can see over here that this is 0 degree, so there is no any angle over here. It means that it is 0 degree. So as it the angle will produce, then it will start from 1 degree, 2 degree, up to 360 degrees. For example, here in this figure you can see over here that this line is raised above. It means it is showing that so the angle is produced. Here it is, for example, 20 degrees. As it will more inclined, it will be 30 degrees, 45 degrees. Now you can see over here that this is straight, this straight line is 90 degrees. As it will more rotate, then it will be 180 degrees, because straight will be 90 degrees and further 90 degrees over here. 90 degrees plus 90 degrees will be 180 degrees, and further it will rotate, it will be 270 degrees, and further rotate and come to its original position, then it will be 360 degrees. So the whole circle has total 360 degrees. Now we come to the radians. Now it is the also unit of angle measurement, but it is the SI unit. Remember, degree is not the SI unit of angle measurement, but radian is the SI unit of angle measurement, and this usually comes in the MCQs, that what is the SI unit of angle measurement. Okay, now we take the concept of the radians. Now you can see over here that this is the circle. So what is radian? You can see over here that this is the circle and this is the radius. Radius, we all know about it. When the arc produced by an angle, the length of the arc should be equal to the length of the radius, then the that theta, that angle will be called as 1 radian. It means 1 radian is equal to, when r or the radius, the length of the radius should be equal to the length of this arc, then the theta will be equal to 1 radian. So when that condition will be produced, when you can see that 1 radian is equal to 180 degree upon pi, you can solve it, you will come to know that it will be 57.29 something degrees. So when this theta or angle will be 57.29 degrees, then radius will be equal to arc, and then it will be equal to 1 radian. The other conditions can also be produced. You can see that, for example, this looks like radius is equal to arc, but sometimes the radius can be smaller than arc. Like you can see over here that, for example, if we increase it angle, then arc will be more than radius, or if we decrease this angle, then arc will be less than radius and the radius will be more. So radius should be equal to arc. Now when that condition will produce, when 1 radian is equal to 180 degree upon pi, so it will be 57.29 degrees. And how we represent the whole circle, when that will be equal to 2 pi r, it means 2 pi radian. Remember, this is not radius, this is radian. When it will be 2 pi radian, it means 2 multiplied by pi multiplied by radian, means 180 degree upon pi. If you multiply all of these, you will see that it will be equal to 360 degrees. So in radians, it is equal to 2 pi r, and in degrees it is equal to 360 degrees. Thank you for watching this video.